sleep. I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall asleep, counting my blessings when my bankroll is getting small. Of when I had none at all, and I fall asleep, counting my blessings. I think about a nursery, and I picture curly heads, and one by one I count them. They slumber in their beds. So if you're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall asleep.
Is a dried corsage. My dad used to take me on father-daughter dates, and I lined them up. I would pin them to the wall, and we had like 10 of them in my bedroom as a child, and I still have them all.
I'm Darren Newton, and this is a teddy bear that we got when my grandpa passed from cancer, and it's made out of his shirt, and it's really special to me because I get to kind of be with him.
My name is Devaney, and I brought these two statues because they represent me and my sister, and that is who I'm grateful for.
Here I have a World War II army knife from my grandfather, who just passed away recently. And behind is a picture of Jesus, knowing that he is in a good place with our Heavenly Father.
My great-grandpa was a geologist, and he made this ring. It's important to me because my grandpa is now passed on, but I'm so grateful for him and what he taught me.
I bought this book because it reminds me of when my parents used to read to me when I was little, and I'm very grateful for my parents.
And this is my Guatemala handbag. I got it from my grandfather, and it just reminds me that of my heritage, and I'm so grateful for it.
So I wanted this project to be all about gratitude, about counting blessings, And one of the ways that I remember my blessings is with this pocket watch. This watch I acquired in England. It's from the 1800s, about from the same era as my great-great-great-grandfather, John Toon. John Toon crossed from England and across the plains with a cello. He actually had one of the first instruments that was here in this valley. He was a member of the first orchestra. And it's been a real blessing to me to remember that I have this connection with someone who came before and helped to pave the way for Lyceum and for all the projects that we do, that I hope really gives back to the community as well. I want to thank the Ashton family for this incredible venue, for allowing us to not only highlight some of their talented grandchildren, but also highlight this gorgeous facility up at the top of Sundance. So if you enjoyed this video, I hope that you'll remember some things that you're grateful for, especially this Christmas, and count your blessings.